The only prize or award I've ever really wanted deep down is a Dundee. These things are awesome. On its face, being nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize is a pretty big deal. Most people, myself included, have never been nominated. So when the news broke in early February that Jared Kushner, the former White House senior advisor and, yes, the son-in-law of the former president, and 2018 Georgia Democratic gubernatorial nominee Stacey Abrams had both been nominated for this year's prizes, the base of both parties went insane. As usual, lots of this outrage was totally misplaced. Welcome to the social media era. It's terrible. Here's the thing. Being nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize is a lot different than actually winning the Nobel Peace Prize, mostly because a whole lot of people can nominate you to be in the running. In fact, here's who can put forward someone for the Peace Prize. This is from none other than the Nobel Prize website. Quote, these nominations will be submitted by members of national assemblies, governments, and international courts of law, university chancellors, professors of social science, history, philosophy, law, and theology, leaders of peace research institutes, and institutes of foreign affairs, previous Nobel Peace Prize laureates, board members of organizations that have received the Nobel Peace Prize, present and past members of the Norwegian Nobel Committee, and former advisors of the Norwegian Nobel Institute, end quote. Man, that's a lot of semicolons. Whew. So in short, there's a lot of people who can nominate you, okay, every single year, which is why ex-President Donald Trump was one of 211 people and 107 organizations nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize back in 2020. Here's Trump from a September 2020 speech, really not getting that being nominated for the prize isn't the same thing as winning it.
NBC, which is one of the most crooked, one of the worst newscasts, with 20 minutes into a half-hour show, they haven't mentioned the Nobel Peace Prize. And then it went through the whole show, and they never mentioned. Then I got nominated for a second one, they never mentioned. And when Barack Hussein Obama got nominated, he didn't know why he was nominated. It was like right at the very beginning. He didn't do anything. He did nothing. And he got nominated. It was the biggest story I've ever seen. But that's okay. In the meantime, we're president and they're not, right?
Sidebar, Trump didn't win either the Nobel Prize or the 2020 election. The former went to the World Food Program, a program of the United Nations for its efforts to combat hunger around the world. The latter went to Joe Biden. End sidebar. So yes, Obama actually did win the Nobel Peace Prize back in 2009 for his, quote, extraordinary efforts to strengthen international diplomacy and cooperation between peoples, end quote. Which was, well, more than a little weird because Obama had only been in office for a month when he was nominated for the Peace Prize and 9 months when he won. And Obama, to his credit, admitted as much, saying he was, quote, surprised and deeply humbled after being chosen. Sidebar, Obama is one of four American presidents to have won the Nobel Peace Prize. Theodore Roosevelt, Woodrow Wilson, and Jimmy Carter are the others. Although interestingly, at least to me, Carter won the prize after leaving the White House. All of which brings me back to Kushner and Abrams and how exactly they made the Nobel nominations list. Great, so in Kushner's case, he was nominated by pro-Trump lawyer Alan Dershowitz for the work he did on Middle East peace while a member of the Trump administration. Dershowitz, in case you're wondering, was eligible to nominate Kushner because he's a professor emeritus of Harvard Law School. Ever heard of it? The high-profile lawyer, that's Dershowitz, emerged as one of then-President Trump's most ardent defenders in his final months in office, even offering to represent the 45th president in his second impeachment trial. Dershowitz wasn't ultimately chosen to be a part of that team, which, not bad. Abrams, on the other hand, was nominated by Lars Haltbrekken, a member of Norway's Socialist Party, for her work on voter registration and rights following her narrow loss to Governor Brian Kemp in Georgia in 2018. Quote, Abrams' work follows in Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s footsteps in the fight for equality before the law and for civil rights, wrote Haltbrekken in the nomination. And in case you're wondering, here are a few other nominees for this year's Nobel Peace Prize. Black Lives Matter movement, climate activist Greta Thunberg, and Russian activist Alexei Navalny. Now, all of those people seem more likely to me to win than Kushner or Abrams, so save your outrage. I'm sure there'll be plenty of other things to get you very angry about very soon. And that is The Point. We make new Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.